हर नमः पार्वती पतये, हर हर महादेवा। आदि पराशक्ति माता की जय। सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय। शुक्लांबरधरं विष्णुं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये। नमः शिवाभ्यां नवयौवनाभ्यां परस्पराश्लिष्टवपुर्धराभ्यां नागेन्द्रकन्यां वृषकेतनाभ्यां नमो नमः शंकर पार्वतीभ्या। गुरवे सर्वलोकानां भिषजे भवरोगिणां नितये सर्वविद्यानां श्री दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। माता तु पार्वती देवी, पिता देवो महेश्वरः। बान्धवाः शिवभक्ताश्च स्वदेशो भुवनत्रयम्। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। बुद्धिर्बलं यशो धैर्यं निर्भयत्वम् अरोगताम् अजाड्यं वाक्पटुत्वं च हनुमत् स्मरणात् भवेत्। हनुमत्स्मरणात् भवे। सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय। हर नमः पार्वती पतये, हर हर महादेवा। लॉर्ड शंभु, द बेस्ट आवर ऑफ हैप्पीनेस एंड ऑस्पिशियसनेस has given us this wonderful opportunity to come together and to indulge ourselves in listening and to understand the meaning of the shlokas of Shivananda Lahari. Every week we try to go deep into the shlokas of Shivananda Lahari. As we go deep, we have all seen that the knowledge seems to be very deep. Initially, it was said that Shivananda Lahari was a bhakti grantham, but this is a bhakti and a jnana grantham. We have got too many knowledge and messages from these shlokas. These shlokas teaches how a person must live in this life. So Adishankaracharya, through his first shloka, paid his obeisances and namaskarams to Lord Shiva and Parvati. He says, Kalabhyam Chudalankrita Shashikalabhyam Nijatapaphalabhyam Bhakteshu प्रकटित फलाभ्याम भवतु मे। शिवाभ्याम अस्तोकत्र भुवन शिवाभ्याम हृदि पुनर्भवाभ्याम आनंद स्फुरदनुभवाभ्याम नतिरियम। He says, that he offers this namaskaram to Lord Shiva and Parvati, who are the source of knowledge. They are the source of beauty and compassion. They are the source of auspiciousness, and they act as the wish yielding tree, not just for their bhakta, but for all the three worlds put together. They keep emerging in the mind and thoughts of all the bhaktas. And as they emerge, they give a sense of anandam. They make us experience that eternal bliss. Spuradanubhavabhyam. They make us experience the explosion of ananda in us. And Adi Shankaracharya has offered his namaskaram not only to Lord Shiva, but also to Ma Parvati, because both of them are inseparable. They are always together and they are one and the same. We cannot find any difference between Lord Shiva and Ma Parvati. That is why we consider Mata Parvati to be our Mata and Maheshwara to be our Pita. Mata tu Parvati Devi, Pita Devo Maheshwarah, Bandhava Shiva Bhaktascha, Swadesho Bhuvanatrayam. We might have enjoyed this shloka even in the previous week's Satsangam, but this shloka is of utmost importance. Only when we start taking it much more deeper, and only when we start thinking about it every day, this thought will get etched in our mind. It says, Mata tu Parvati Devi. Ma Parvati is our mother. Pita Devo Maheshwarah. Maheshwara is our father. Bandhava Shiva Bhaktashtra. All those who feel the same way become Shiva Bhakta. All those who have an attachment towards Parvati and Parameshwara become Shiva Bhakta. And all those in the world who join, who come together to do Shiva Bhakti, become our relatives. Now we are all related because we are all Shiva Bhaktas. We have all come together to involve ourselves in Shiva Bhakti. Bandhava Shiva Bhaktascha Swadesho Bhuvanatrayam. And when we start considering everyone as our family member, our house is not the house that we live in. It is not the city. It is not the town. It is not the state. It is not the country that we live in. But our house is all three worlds put together. Swadesho Bhuvanatrayam. We should start this bhavam in us. We should start experiencing this in us. We cannot say that Lord Shiva and Parvati are just gods and we like to keep them only in our puja sannidhi. That should not be the attitude. Only if we take steps towards them, they will start coming towards us. Only if we start looking at them with some bhava, they will start looking at us with the same bhava. Yad bhavam tad bhavati. If you look at Lord Shiva as your father, he will look at you as his son. If you look at Lord Shiva as his friend, he will start seeing you as a friend. When you see Lord Shiva as the beloved, he will start looking at you as the beloved. So, yad bhavam tad bhavatani. The most easiest way to attain Lord is to see him as a father. Because if we have a problem, we reach out to our parents first. When a child commits a mistake, when a child has a problem, that child goes to the parents first. Sometimes, father might punish that child to bring him back to the right track. And at that point of time, mother will show affection and embrace that child. Sometimes mother might be strict with the child. At that point of time, father will come to embrace the child and show his affection. Whatever the case is, we will always have one person to punish us and the other person to embrace us. Or both of them will punish and both of them in a very short span of time will come back to us and will embrace us. Vallala, a great bhakta of Lord Shiva, sings in his Thiru Arutpa, Taditthavor magadelle Thandaiyin taditta Thayudan anaippal Thayadittal Pidittor thandai anaippal இங்கு நக்க பேசிய தந்தையும் தாயும் பொடித்திருமேனி அம்பலத்தாடும் புனிதா நீ ஆதலால் என்னை அடித்தது போதும் He says, Ammayappa, O Nataraja, O Chidambaranatha, for everyone else, this rule might apply. For everyone else, they might have one person to scold and the other person to show love and affection. But for me, O Chidambaranatha, I have only one father and mother in the same form, and that is the Nataraja form. Ingenakku pesiya thandaiyum thaayum podi thirumeni ambalathaadum pudida. I see father and mother in your form, in your Nataraja form. You are my father, you are my mother. And that is why we call Lord Shiva as Tayu Manavan, Matru Bhuteshwaran. And he is the Ardhanarishwaran because Shiva and Parvati are in the same form. So Vallalar says, oh Shiva, for me, you are my father and you are my mother. And I am constantly punished. I am always put into the torture mode. You know why? Because this samsaram is always like that. I am not getting liberated from this samsaram. I am not able to reach out to you. I am facing so many problems here, so much of sorrow here, and this is torturing me. Nee aadalal ennai adithathu podum. I have been punished all these years, all these births. I am constantly put into the torture mode. I have been put into many situations where I have to face happiness, sorrow, joy, everything, defeat, failure, everything. And this is tormenting. When will I get liberated from all these? I started my journey from your abode, but I'm still wandering here. When will I reach you, O Shiva? So, enough of this drama. Let us close this drama once and for all. Adithathu podum. Please stop this punishment. Anaithidal vendum. I want you to embrace me. I want you to hug me. I want you to take me in your lap and tell me that, oh son, this torture is over. This punishment is over. And you have come back to me. ஆதலால் அம்மையப்பா இனி மாற்றே அம்மை அப்பா யூ ஆர் மை ஃபாதர் அண்ட் மை மதர் ஸோ ஐ கேனாட் டாலரேட் திஸ் எனி மோர் says Vallalar. So the ultimate destination for all beings in this world is to attain Lord Shiva. We are constantly wandering here. We are roaming here. We are not going after the real happiness. We are not going after the eternal happiness. And that is what Adi Shankaracharya emphasizes in the second shloka. He says, Shiva Ananda Lahari. This Lahari is a torrential flow. And it gives us anandam, bliss. And this bliss arises in our heart when we think about Lord Shiva, when we talk about him, when we hear about him, when we do some kaintaryam which is related to him. And this anandam, this bliss is eternal and this must stay in us forever. So he tells us how this ananda can stay in us forever. In the second shloka, Adi Shankaracharya says, Talanti Shambho Tvacharita Sarita Kilbishara Jodalanti Bhikulya Saranishu Patanti Vijayatam Dishanti Samsara Brahmanata Popa Shamanam Vasanti Macheto Hradabhuri Shivananda Lahari Galanti Shambho Tvacharita Sarita Kilbishara Jodalanti Bhikulya Saranishu Patanti Vijayatam Dishanti samsara bhramana tapopashamalam Vasanti macheto hradabhuvi Shivananda Lahari. In this shloka, Adi Shankaracharya has explained this concept very beautifully. This is an abstract concept which cannot be understood by everyone. So he makes it into an image. He creates an image in front of us. And he says, look, this is how Shivananda Lahari is. And this is how you can keep it in your mind always. This type of alankaram, figure of speech, which Adi Shankaracharya has used in this shloka is called Rupaka Alankar. When some message has to be conveyed by the use of something which is near us, something in the nature, then that figure of speech is called Rupaka Alankar. In fact, Adi Shankaracharya likes playing with words. In the first shloka, if we have noticed, we will find Kalabhyam Chudalankrita Shashi Kalabhyam. Kalabhyam will come again. Neither the first line is over. Second line. Phalabhyam Bhakteshu Prakatita Phalabhyam. We will find Phalabhyam again in the second line. Third line. Shivabhyam Astokatribhuvana Shivabhyam. We find Shivabhyam in the second adjective also. Hridipunaha, fourth line. Bhavabhyam Anandaspuradanu Bhavabhyam. We find Bhavabhyam again. So Kalabhyam Chodalankrita Shashi Kalabhyam. Phalabhyam Bhakteshu Prakatita Phalabhyam. Shivabhyam Astokatribhuvana Shivabhyam. Bhavabhyam Anandaspuradanu Bhavabhyam. So Adi Shankaracharya likes using all these phrases. He likes playing with words. So in a similar fashion, he explains this shloka, the second shloka, by painting a picture in front of us. He says, imagine a river. And that river is filled with water and the water starts trickling down. passes through various canals and channels and stream. And let us assume that the stream was dry previously. It has not received water in the past few months. So it was dry all along. It was hot all along. So this water starts gushing down. As it gushes down, the first wave, the first set of stream will wash off all the dirt and impurity which is found in that stream or the channel. If there are any blocks in a path, that will be removed. That will be washed away. And in the first stream, all impurity and all the dirt particles will be washed away. As this water flows through this land, this barren land, this land will feel happiness because it was dry all along. It was facing heat all along. So when water flows on this land will have a soothing effect. It will be calm and peaceful, and it will be very happy to welcome that water flow. And people around that land will also find happiness in them. They will feel some cooling effect. They will find that they are very happy when they see the water flowing. They would like to preserve this water because this seems to be visiting them once in a year or twice in a year only. So they wanted to save this water. What would they do? They will streamline this water to some tank or pond or lake, and they will store that water there. So this is the picture. Water gushes out of the river. It comes down, and as it comes down, it washes out all impurities in the way. And now the path becomes clean. And the water keeps flowing. It gives a soothing effect in all those places where heat and dryness was experienced all along. And this water is collected in a lake or a pond or a stream for use in future. So this is the picture which Adi Shankaracharya creates for us. What is the message that he is trying to convey? Galanti Shambho Tvacharita Saritah. He says, O Lord Shiva, O Shambho, water from your river flows down. Galanti means trickling down. What is that river? Tvacharita Saritah. There's a river filled with qualities, charitas, leelas or gunas of you. It is that river which has everything about you. It might be your quality. It might be the adventures that you have taken up. It might be your leelas. It might be your gunas. It might be anything. Anything and everything related to you is filled in that river, and water from that river flows down. When it flows down, it should wash away some dirt and impurities in its way. So, in the same way, this water washes down. This water tries to remove all the impurities that I have. We say mental block. We say that we are not open to new things. What is that mental block? It is the ignorance that we have. And that ignorance stops us from going out and learning new things. When we start listening to Lord Shiva's stories, when we start receiving this water, then this impurity, this ignorance is washed out. Not only that, our sin, our papa is also washed away. All the sinful activities that we have committed gets washed out. Kilbishara jo adalanti. all these are washed away. Not only does our sinful activity go away, but also the tendency to commit that activity is also washed away. So as it gets washed away, this water starts flowing in. All along we were having mental blocks, and now these blocks are removed. As these are removed, the channels become free. There's a free flow of water, and through our brain, through our mind, water starts flowing in. Dhi kulya, dhi means mind. Dhi kulya paranishu patante. This water flows into us through our mind. Because as we start acquiring knowledge, we start getting more inclined towards Lord Shiva. So it is knowledge, is the inner eye which must open up first. And once that is opened, then water starts flowing in very easy. Dishanti samsara bhramana tapo pashamanam. This water keeps flowing in us. But what effect does it create? We are all roasted in many type of heat, tapam. We are all constantly wandering in this world. Samsara bhramana. And the samsara bhramana, wandering in samsara, is treated like a tapam, the heat that we face in us. This heat or this dryness in our life must go away. So when this water starts coming into us, it removes all heat and all dryness which we face in our life. The samsara is itself very dry and rough. We are always tired wandering. So this water acts as a cooling effect to us. Let us assume that we go out on a summer day afternoon for shopping. Most of the cities would be facing summer now. And definitely we would have gone out for shopping if this was not a lockdown period. So we would have gone out and we would have been burnt in the sun, right? At that point of time, if we have a cool juice, if we have some juice, if we have coconut water, how would it feel? What effect would it give? Or after roaming everywhere, if we get into a showroom which is air conditioned, how would you feel? The same way, samsara bhramana has made us all tired. We keep roaming, and we don't know where our destination is. We just keep roaming. We know that we have to attend Lord Shiva, but we have not found our way back home. We have not found our way to attend Shiva. So we are just roaming and we are totally tired. And now, when his stories come into us, when this water gushes into us, how would we all feel? How peaceful it would be? So Adi Shankaracharya says, that is the peace that we all experience when we listen to Adi Shankaracharya's Shiva's stories. Guru story or Lord story, whatever it is, when listened and when pondered upon, will give us eternal happiness. And that is what Shankaracharya is feeling. And he says, this feeling must be everlasting. He doesn't want this to go away. He wants this to be in him always. So he says, Vasanti Macche Tohrada Bhuvi Shivananda Lahari. Shiva Ananda Lahari, let this wave stay in my heart always, which is poured in through the channel of my brain, my mind, and it goes in and let it get collected in my heart and let it stay there always. There is a lake, there is a pond in me, and that is my heart. So let it stay there always. Hrada Bhuvi Shivananda Lahari. Let it stay there constantly and let it give me this peace always, says Adi Shankaracharya. This is the outwardly meaning. If we go deep into the tattva, Adi Shankaracharya says, in the first word itself, he addresses Lord Shiva as Shambhu. Sham bhavayati iti Shambhu. That person who is present wherever good things are spoken, good things are heard, good things are done. So he is present wherever good actions are performed. And Sham utpadayati iti Shambhu. He is that person who creates good feelings in everyone. So if we have all joined here to listen to his story, it is because he wants us to listen to this story. He wants me to talk about his story. And he wants all of us to get involved in the satsangam. Avan arulale avan thaal vanangi. So it is because of him that we are all here. And it is because of his sankalpa, we are all able to think about him. So, sham bhavayati iti shambhu. Sham utpadayati iti shambhu. He is the one who creates good things. And he is the one who is present wherever good things are there. And this Shambhu is present in all of us now. When we hear to his tales, when we constantly listen to his story, what happens? That water starts trickling in us, it comes in us. What type of impurities gets washed away? He says, Kilbisha Rajo Dalanti. Our sins get washed away. This river is a river that we cannot measure. That we cannot imagine. Svacharita saritaha. If one shloka of Shivananda Lahari can take us too deep into his thought, then imagine what if we complete all 100 shlokas. This is not the only shloka of Lord Shiva. There are numerous shlokas for Lord Shiva. Vedas talk about Lord Shiva. There are numerous songs which praise Lord Shiva. And think how deep this river would be and how big this river would be. Svacharita saritaha. This river is indeed very big and very deep. And from that, I receive a stream. This might be a very small stream for me, but it has a strong current in it because as it comes, it washes out all my sins. The speciality of this stream is, generally, we say that all our sin gets washed away if we take a bath in Ganga. Ganga is considered to be the most sacred river. So if we take a bath in Ganga, all our sins gets washed away. But if we take a bath in this river, Vacharita Saritaha, in this river, which has everything about you, your glories, your gunas, your charita, your leela, everything. When I take a deep bath in it, when I take a deep dip in it, then not only does it wash away my impurities, not only does it wash away my papa, it also washes away my tendency to do that papa, my tendency to commit that sin. Let us say that a person gets involved in a crime. That is a sinful act. And he has accumulated some papa, some sin. He goes to Ganga. He takes a bath there and his sin goes away. But does his intention to create that sin get washed away? No. But if one takes a deep dip into this river, then his intention to commit that sin also gets washed away. Kilbisha Rajo Dalanti. Because this stream has a strong current and this hits our ego. Here by ego I mean I, mine. As long as we say I, mind, we cannot attain true bhakti at all. These two words are extremely dangerous for everyone. I, mind. In fact, everything in this world is connected to I, mind. Who is the most favorite person for all of us? Our own self. Because we like others only when they act favorably, only when they act friendly. If someone intends to do some harm to us, will we like them? So ultimately, we like our own self. And we not only like our own self, we love our own self. We are always concerned about our own self. And that is where problems are created. When we focus too much on our own self, then kamam, krodham, lobham, moham, madam, matsaryam, everything starts coming up. Everything starts sprouting. So this stream will ensure that it goes and hits the tendency to do this sin, the tendency to commit such a sin, by hitting our ego and by telling us that Lord Shiva is the ultimate supreme being. It hits us so hard that we will start understanding the true nature of this samsara sagaram, and we will start realizing how harmful it is for us, and we will start understanding that Lord Shiva is our ultimate destination. So that is the power of this stream. Kilbisha rajo dalanti dhi kulya saranishu patanti. So this stream flows into us. It flows in through our mind by clearing all blocks. All the mental block that we have and the ignorance that we have is washed out. So now all the paths become very clean and there is an easy flow of knowledge in us. So, dhi kulya saraneshu patanti. Why does all these things happen? Dishanti samsara bhramana tapopa shamanam. We saw that samsara bhramanam, moving here and there in the samsara, creates a lot of stress and restlessness in us. We try to reach out to something which is temporary, which is not permanent. We all know about Maslow's hierarchy theory. Our needs are insatiable and it keeps increasing. Once our basic needs are satisfied, we want to go to the safety need. We want social status. We want security. And we keep increasing our needs more and more. Even after we achieve self-actualization goal, we need something more than that. We need to achieve something more every day. If we are given 2 lakh rupees today, we will not be happy. Trust me. We will ask that person for 5 lakh rupees. And if that person gives you 5 lakh rupees, you will go ask that person for 10 lakh rupees. And this growth in our need is not something which is arithmetical. It is exponential. It is always a geometric progression. We want more, more, more from this world. And remember, when we start expecting more from the samsara, which is just an illusion, that is the time we start going more deep into the samsara, more deep into this ocean. And if we start going more deep into it, then there cannot be anyone to pull us out of this. A person can be pulled out if he's somehow shallow, if he's in the upper surface. But if he has gone to the ocean bed already, how can someone pull him out that easily? So, we must not get more attached to all these things. And these things will only create confusion among us. This samsara bhramanam is illusionary. We go after temporary happiness and we become proud about that and we start having arrogance about it. In Bhaja Govindam, Adi Shankaracharya sing, Ma Kuru Dhar. जन जन यौवन गर्वम हरति निमेषात् काल सर्वम महापुरु जन जन यौवन गर्वम हरति निमेषात् काल सर्वम मायामयमिदं अखिलं हित्वा ब्रह्मपदं त्वं प्रविश विदित्वा ब्रह्मपदं त्वं प्रविश विदित्वा भज गोविंदं गोविंदं भज मूढ़मते। आदि शंकराचार्य से मा कुरु धन जन यौवन गर्वम। डोंट बी अरोगेंट इफ यू आर वेल्थी और इफ यू हैव टू मेनी फॉलोअर्स और फ्रेंड्स विथ यू और इफ यू आर यंग। दीज आर नॉट गोइंग टू हेल्प यू एट एनी कॉस्ट। यू माइट थिंक दैट द वेल्थ दैट यू हैव अक्वायर्ड इज बिकॉज ऑफ योर ओन एफर्ट। दीज एफर्ट्स और दीज टैलेंट दैट यू पोसेस might be acquired or inherited. If it's inherited, it is not because of you that you have attained it. If you have acquired it, even at that point of time, you have not created it. Someone has assisted you in creating the talent in you. So we can be arrogant of something or we can claim ownership of something which we have created. We have not created this wealth. We have not created followers. If those followers, if we look into our Facebook or Instagram, if we have too many followers, we must not be arrogant about it because we have not created it. Leave the followers, that person as a whole. Have we created them? They are a part of this nature and we are also a part of this nature. Have we created them? Yavana garvam. We might think we are just 20, we are just 25. Or probably 30, and we have the entire life in our hand, and we can achieve all the things that we want for in this world. Please remember that this situation that we are all facing is the best example to show that ma kuru dhanajana yauvana garvam. Don't be arrogant about your wealth, people you have around you, or your youth. This situation is totally impartial. This disease doesn't see if you are a wealthy person or a poor person. It doesn't see if you are young or old. It doesn't see if you have too many followers or if you're isolated. If you have to leave, then you have to leave. Harati nimeshat kala sarvam. Kalam or yama can destroy all these in 1 second because mayamayamidam akhilam hitva brahmapadam tvam pravisha vidhitva. This entire world is illusionary. And what do you gain out of this? You might be happy today with the 10 lakhs that you have got. But if it's not there the next moment, will you be able to accept the fact? If you get this disease today, will you be able to accept the fact? Trust me, for the next 15 days, you cannot even assure that you will be alive. So, to that extent, we have no control over anything in this world, but we have control over one thing, that is the Brahmanandam that we all experience every day, the Shivananda Lahari that we all experience every day. And when that is there in us, nothing can stop us from attaining Lord Shiva. That is the Anandam, that bliss that we have created, and it differs from person to person. And if we are successful in retaining it in our heart after our ego being hit, then that is the true wealth that we must all possess, and that is something which will stay with us permanently. Brahma padam tvam pravisha viditva. Why don't you enter into spiritual activities? Why don't you enter into that zone where where everyone talks or listens to or sings about Lord Shiva. So, Bhaja Govindam, Bhaja Govindam, Govindam, Bhaja Mudhamati. Oh, foolish one, you think that you can control this world, but you cannot control this world. This entire world is controlled but by that Paramatma, by that ultimate supreme being. You are also being controlled by him. So don't try controlling anything. You are trying to control something which is not possible. You are trying to control something which belongs to others. Why don't you try controlling your own self? Do you think it's possible? Do you think you can control your own mind? A question which we all have to think deeply. For this 1.5 hours or 1 hour 15 minutes, including me, we would have all gone to a different zone and come back here at least for a minute. We are not able to control our own mind. Forget about controlling the world. Forget about fortune. Our own mind cannot come under our control, and it can never be in peace. It is always wavering. And this is something which is experienced even by Arjuna. He says, Chanchalam hi manah Krishna, pramathi balavad dridham in Bhagavad Gita. He says, if it is lit, a deepa is lit, and if a fan is kept near there, that light will keep flickering, the diya will keep flickering. In the same way, my mind keeps flickering. It keeps wandering here and there. What do I do for it? This is the same feeling which Sadashiva Brahmendra, a great Paramahamsa yogi, experiences. He sings, Thirata nahi nahi je, Thirata nahi nahi je. मानस स्थिरता नहीं नहीं रे 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 तापत्रय सागर मग्नानां सागर मग्नानां दर्पहं कर विमग्नानां दर्पहं कर विमग्नानां स्थिरता नहीं नहीं रे मानस स्थिरता नहीं नहीं रे मानस स्थिरता नहीं नहीं रे ए विषय पाश वेष्टित चित्तानां विषय पाश वेष्टित चित्तानां विपरीत ज्ञान
विमतानां विपरीत ज्ञान विमतानां स्थिरता नहीं नहीं रे मानस स्थिरता नहीं नहीं रे मानस स्थिरता नहीं नहीं रे परमहंस योग विरुद्धानां परमहंस योग विरुद्धानां बहुचंचल कर सुख सिद्धानां बहुचंचल कर सुख सिद्धानां स्थिरता नहीं नहीं रे मानस स्थिरता नहीं नहीं रे मानस स्थिरता नहीं नहीं रे
स्थिरता नहीं नहीं रे दिस माइंड कैन नॉट बी ब्रॉट अंडर आवर कंट्रोल दिस इज वेरी एविडेंट विद दोस पीपल हु आर रोस्टेड इन द स्कॉर्चिंग हीट तापत्रय आध्यात्मिकम आदि भौतिकम अनादि दैविकम विषय विपरीत ज्ञान विमत्तानम दोस हु आर इंफ्लिक्टेड विद misinterpretation, those who don't know the true knowledge, those who try to get deep into Shastra but end up misinterpreting it, they can never be at peace. They will only try to defend their statement of misinterpretation. Darpahankara vilaknanam, all those who are caged by arrogance and pride can never experience peace. Those who are always engrossed in the materialistic pleasures can never experience peace. Paramahamsa yoga viruddhana bahu chanchala para sukha siddhana. Those who always run behind temporary happiness can never experience peace. And those who are against the Paramahamsa principle. Paramahamsa principle is that principle where all the yogis see Lord Shiva everywhere. Even if it's a non-living being, they see Lord Shiva in it. And they see Lord Shiva in their own self. They are not worried about their body. Sadashiva Brahmendra, for instance, faced a situation where his hand got cut. He didn't even know that his hand was cut. And someone had to come and give his hand to him. And he said, oh, is my hand cut? And he just placed it where it was and he started walking. And it got stuck. There was no surgery which he underwent. But still it got stuck. So they don't care about their body. They are not bound by rules and regulations. So that is the Paramahamsa principle. And those who are against it or those who cannot understand it can never realize ultimate peace and ultimate bliss. So, we are all wandering here and there. Vishyanti samsaram bhavana tapa. We are all searching for something in this world. We are not finding peace anywhere. We are totally tired. We want someone to help us. And if at that point of time, we get this stream in us, if we get this flow in us, and if we start contemplating about Lord Shiva, then think about the peace that we would get. If we feel that this samsara is being cruel to us, and if we listen to Lord Shiva's story on the other hand, we will not get peace. because the river from which the stream flows is the river of compassion. All the stories that he has, all the leelas that he has performed is for his bhaktas. So even if we commit any mistake, he will come running to us and he will save us. So will that thought give us any harm? Will it not make us more peaceful? Will it not make us experience eternal bliss in us? So when this stream flows in us, when it comes into us, we will experience the bliss in us. We will experience eternal peace in us. And Adi Shankaracharya says, don't stop with that. This might flow out and you might have to bring that stream into you again. So instead, try locking it in your heart. Vasanti machi to hrada bhuvi shivananda lahaji. Store it in your heart always, so that your heart doesn't go out searching for Lord Shiva and other things. It starts searching him in you. And what an anandam that we would face if we have Shiva anandam in us. This Shiva anandam is the base for all anandam. Shruti says, etasvai anandasi anyani bhutani matram upajivanti. Whether it be the temporary materialistic pleasure or the paramanandam, all these are based on Shivanandam. Shivanandam is there, then we will get materialistic pleasure or paramanandam. It depends on what we ask, but Shivanandam is the base for everything. And manasparam karana mamananti samsara chakram parivarta yedyat. This manas, this mind, is the root cause of all sorrows. So if we try putting it in its place, and if we try bringing it into our control, and if we succumb it to Shivananda Lahari, then nothing can stop us from achieving our destination and from attaining Lord Shiva. So Adi Shankaracharya says, let this Lahari be victorious. Shivananda Lahari Vijayatam. Let this Lahari, let this wave be victorious. We have too many waves in us. We have Kama Lahari, we have Krodha Lahari, we have Lobha Lahari. We have too many emotions in us, but we don't have tranquility in us. When we get that, let us lock it up. So he says, let this Lahari, let this wave be constant in me. Let this be victorious over the other Lahari, over the other waves that I experience always. Let me not face any mood swing. Let me not succumb myself to kamam, krodham, lobham, moham, madam, matsaryam. But instead, let me succumb to Shivananda Lahari and let it take over me. Let it control my mind. Let it control all the indriyas that I've got. Let it control all the sense organs that I've got. And let it ultimately take me to Lord Shiva. Says Adi Shankaracharya through this shloka in Shivananda Lahari. So he urges us to think about Lord Shiva always, to hear about Lord Shiva always. How can the stream come into us? There should be a means through which it must flow in us. Shravanam is the best way to get this stream in us. Because when we hear the glories or the shlokas or the praises of Lord Shiva, it gets accumulated in us even without our knowledge. Many a times we would have faced the situation where we would not have paid any attention to our class, to our teachers, but somehow the lesson that he or she taught must have gone deeper into us, and when we wrote our exam, it would have helped us. So this is not something which is new to us. In fact, this was something which even Arjuna faced. When Bhagavad Gita was told, Arjuna said, Shishyasteham Shadhimam Vam Prapandam. Please accept me as your Shishya please act as my guru and tell me what is right and wrong. And he got all 700 shlokas. He fought the battle. He won. And Yudhishthira became the crowned king. And they were all living peacefully. One fine day, when Arjuna and Krishna were walking, Arjuna asked Krishna, "Oh Krishna, I remember you telling something to me on the first day of battle. I remember you telling something which was very important, which pushed me to fight. I remember that it was enthusiastic and motivating, but I don't remember the exact content that you told. Can you repeat it?" This was the plight which Arjuna faced, him being the only student of Lord Krishna. He had the full attention of Lord Krishna on him. He had special attention, and Arjuna was totally focused. We all know how Arjuna focused. We know the story where Arjuna focused only on the eye of that bird to hit it. So he was very focused, but still he couldn't remember those things. So Lord Krishna told him once again everything. Even then he couldn't understand it. But when Lord Krishna left this world and then he went to Vaikuntha, at that point of time, Arjuna realized all these things. He started telling that Lord Krishna was the Paramatma. He was the Supreme Brahman. And he started telling everything that he knew from the Shastras and the Vedas and everything that he has learned from Krishna to all the Pandavas. How did he get there? He didn't put much effort. He only had to listen. And that is the same for us also. In fact, in Bhagavatam, Vidura says to Maitreya, "Yah karnanadim purushasya yataha bhava pradam yeharatam chinanti." If we listen more, then all the glories, all the stories get accumulated in us. And it will help us cut all the bondages that we have in the samsara. It will help us cut family affection. And it will give us liberation from the cycle of birth and death. We might not know when this will help us, but all that we have to do is to listen. This 1 hour or the 1 hour 15 minutes that we spend here every week is our investment. The more we listen, the more his gunas or his stories or his leelas get into us. And this will definitely help us when we need its help. So, Shravanam is the most easiest path to attain Lord Shiva. And through Shravanam, the stream of knowledge can come into us and it can stay in our heart eternally. And this is what Adi Shankaracharya requests everyone. He says, "Please bless me with this Shivananda Lahari. And please bless me that this Shivananda Lahari must stay in my heart forever." So with this, the second shloka comes to an end. And we will go to the third shloka. We will just see what is there in the third shloka, and we will continue the third shloka in the next week. Satsangam. Trayi Vedyam Hridyam Tripuraharamadyam Trinayanam Jata Bharodaram चलदुरगहारं मृगधरं महादेवं देवं मयि सदयभावं पशुपतं चिदालंबं सांबं शिववति विदंबं हृदि भजे. इन दिस श्लोक आदि शंकराचार्य डिस्क्राइब्स द वेरियस गुणा और द वेरियस लीलास which Lord Shiva has performed, and he wants his heart to keep singing about all these again and again. Hridi bhaje. He says, Trayi Vedyam, who is the source of all Vedas and who is known through all these three Vedas. Hridyam, who is the most beloved person. Tripurahara Madhyam, who was the slayer of Tripurasura. Trinayanam, he has three eyes. Jata Bharodaram, He has matlocks. Chaladuragahar. He has moving snake as his ornament. Mrigadharam. He holds mriga, that is deer, in his hand. Mahadevam. He is the Mahadeva. Devam. He is the Deva. Mayi sadaya bhavam Pashupati. He who pours compassion and love and affection to all the bhaktas, as he is the Pashupati. Chidalambam, who is filled with self-consciousness. Sambam, who is always with Ambal, always with Parvati. Shivamati vidambam hridibhaji. So he can be understood only through the shlokas, stotras and vedas. So that Shiva must always stay in my heart and I must always praise him. Praise Adi Shankaracharya. So let us all try to hear more about Lord Shiva. Let us try to spend more time in knowing about Lord Shiva. Let us try to involve and indulge ourselves in more satsangam sessions, so that the Shivananda Lahari that we experience right now stays in our heart forever. And this enables us to attain Lord Shiva ultimately. Hara Namah Parvati Pataye. Hara Hara Mahadeva. सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय. आदि पराशक्ति माता की जय. समस्त भक्त मंडली की जय. समस्त साधु मंडली की जय. आंजनेय स्वामी की जय.